Hello viewer, it's my pleasure to welcome you all for learning the civil engineering concepts.
Types of bolted joint. Generally, the bolted joints are classified into two types. One is lap joint, another one is butt joint. The lap joint, the plates to be connected are overlapped each other and connected together by using the bolts is called lap joint. See, this figure shows the lap joint. Okay. Depends upon the number of bolts lines used. It may be a single bolted or double bolted or triple bolted lap joints. See, in this figure, we are connecting the two plates. In the cross section, I am able to see the only one bolt. But in that row, we may have many number of bolts. If we provide only one row of bolt, means that is called single bolted lap joint. If we use, see this cross section, see this one, we have two lines of bolts, therefore this is called double bolted lap joints. In the single bolted lap joint, see this one, single bolted lap joint, the force is in the top plate, force is acting in this direction, bottom plate force is acting in the center of this direction. There is a small gap in between the CG of these forces, that is called eccentricity. The single bolted lap joint have a eccentricity. Due to this eccentricity, the plates will bend. That is the main drawback of this lap joint. To avoid this eccentricity, at least we have to use the two rows of bolts, that is double bolted lap joint is recommended to avoid the eccentricity. See this behavior of this. Even this also having a small eccentricity. After applying this force, it will deflect like this. Then CG will coincide. So eccentricity is avoided. Okay. So double bolted lap joint is recommended. Next we will discuss about the butt joint. The butt joint, we have to place the plates to be connected end to end, and it has to be then by using the cover plates we can connect these plates. If we provide cover plates on only one side, means either top or bottom, it is called single cover butt joint. If you provide the plates on both the side, means that is called double cover butt joint. If you use only one row of bolt, see this figure. Only one row of bolt on either plate with only one cover plate, means this is called single cover, single bolted butt joint. You can consider this, it is having the two cover plates, top and bottom, this having the two bolt lines. Therefore, this can be called as double cover, double bolted butt joint. In this case, CG will be coincide, so comparatively, butt joint will give the good strength. This is a quiz time. The question for you is, which one of the following failure mode cannot be eliminated by providing proper pitch, edge and end distance? Cleavage failure. You have four options. Press pause button and think over and choose your answer. Your time starts now. Answer is option C, bearing failure of the plate. We cannot avoid two failure modes. One is shear failure, another one is bearing failure. Other failure modes can be delayed or completely eliminated by providing proper pitch and edge distance. What do you mean by pitch? This is the center to center distance between the fasteners measured in the direction of load. The same center to center distance between the fastener measured opposite to the direction of force, opposite to the direction of force will give the gauge. End or edge distance is the distance from the edge of the plate to the center of the fastener. Now we will see the codal provisions for the design of the bearing type bolts. Section 10 of the IS 800 deals with the connections. Now we will just move on to the bearing type bolts. This is the bearing type bolt. Section 10.3 deals with bearing type bolts. Our aim is to calculate the strength of the one bolt, that is the design strength of the bolt, or also called as a bolt value, that can be indicated by a symbol of VDP. VDP is the design strength of the bolt, that is smaller of VDSP and VDPP. Now we will see what is meant by VDSP. VDSP is the shear capacity of the bolt. VDSP equal to VNSP by gamma MB. VNSP equal to nominal shear capacity of the bolt. I will directly substitute this formula here, and I can write the VDSP equal to Fu by root 3 NNANP plus NSASB into 1 by gamma MP, where Fu is the ultimate tensile strength of the bolt that depends upon the grade of the bolt. If you use a 4.6 grade bolt, what is your ultimate tensile strength of the bolt? 4 into 100 will give the 400 megapascal, that is the ultimate tensile strength of the bolt. If you use the 5.6 grade bolt, the ultimate tensile strength will be the 500. 5 into 100 will give the 500 megapascal. Then where NN, what is meant by NN? Number of shear planes with threads intercepting the shear plane. Then NS is the number of shear planes without threads intercepting the shear plane. ASB is the nominal plane sung area of the bolt. ASB is the net shear area of the bolt at threads. Suppose I am connecting the two plates by using these bolts. It is having only one interface. I am having a shearing plane here. Due to the shearing plane, the bolt will shear out. If it happens at the threaded portion, means and take that NN equal to 1 in this case. Suppose this shear plane is in the sung area, because we have two types of bolts. One is partially threaded bolt, another one is fully threaded bolt. Partially threaded bolts have a sung area, then threaded portion. Depending upon the whether shear plane cuts threaded portion or sung portion, we have to substitute the value of either NN or NS. I recommend you to always assume that shear plane is passing through the threaded portion, because for example, the contractor want to buy a bolt from the shop. He went to the shop asking for a partially threaded bolt. Shopkeeper said, there is no stock in the partially threaded bolt. I have a fully threaded bolt. I will offer 20% discount for you. Contractor likes the deal. If he purchased the fully threaded bolts, if he used that one, what will happen? It will fail. Your design assumption is wrong. You are assuming that shear plane is passing through the sung portion, but contractor using fully threaded portion, shear plane is passing through the threaded portion. The threaded portion is having a lesser area than the sung area. It will fail easily. Why we want to take risk? To avoid that risk, always assume that shear plane is passing through the threaded portion. Sung area can be easily calculated by using the formula pi d squared by 4, where d is the nominal diameter of the bolt. Net area is threaded portion's area will be little lesser than the sung area. That value varies from 0.7 to 1 according to the number of threads per run. You are not able to calculate the number of threads per run, sir. I will use the lowest range, 0.7. 0.7 times pi d squared by 4. That will give the threaded portion cross-sectional area. This shear capacity has to be reduced in three cases. One is long joints. The joints distance is between the bolt line. The first bolt to the last bolt will be the length of the joint. If the length of the joint exceeds 15 times diameter in the direction of the load, means we have to reduce the shear capacity of the bolt by using the reduction factor calculated in this relation. Then coming to the crypt length. Crypt length is the total thickness of the plates connected. If the crypt length total thickness exceeds 5 times the diameter, nominal diameter of the bolt, means you have to reduce the shear capacity by multiplying the reduction factor. That can be calculated by using this relation. Coming to the packing plate. When the packing plate will come into picture, if you are making a butt joint by using the two plates of different thickness, suppose it is 20 mm, this one is 10 mm, then how we can join this one by using bolt? You have to provide the additional 10 mm by using a packing plate. Either we can use cover plate on one side or both the sides. If the packing plate thickness exceeds 6 mm, means you have to again reduce the shear capacity of the bolt by using this relation. Then now coming to the bearing capacity of the bolt. The bearing capacity of the bolt VDPP can be calculated by using this relation VNPP by gamma MP. VNPP is this one. I can directly write that VDPP equal to 2.5 Kp dT Fu into 1 by gamma MP, where Kp is smaller of E by 3D naught, P by 3D naught minus 0.25, Fu B by Fu comma 1. To use these relations, first we have to know the value of E, then P, then what is by D naught, what is by FUB, what is by FU, where E is the end distance or edge distance. Before assuming that value, you have to refer the caudal provisions. Let us start with the E value, edge distance. For that, you have to refer the class 10.2.4.2. The minimum edge and end distance from the center of any hole to the nearest edge of the plate shall not be less than 1.7 times hole diameter in case of sheared or hand flame cut edges, 1.5 times hole diameter in case of rolled or machine flame cut, shorn and planed edges. I always recommend you to use the value of edge distance as 1.7 times hole diameter, because we can't ensure the contractor may followed the rules exactly. Suppose if the contractor wants to cut a plate, means what he will do? If we have a machine flame cut arrangement also, means we can do that. In that case, we can assume 1.5 times hole diameter. If everything is not available, what he will do? By using the flame of the welding machine, he will cut the plate. Then edges will be undulated and sheared. In that case, you have to use 1.7 times hole diameter. Why we want to take risk? In all the cases, we can assume that the edge distance or end distance is 1.7 times hole diameter. This is the minimum recommended value. It should not exceed maximum value. Assumed value should not exceed maximum value. At least provide minimum value. The maximum value is, maximum edge distance is calculated by using 12T into epsilon. T is the thickness of the thinner outer plate, where epsilon equal to 250 by Fy power 1 by 2. For Indian made structural steel having a yield strength of 250 MPa. You can substitute that value in this equation. You can get the epsilon value equal to 1. Why we are using this epsilon, sir? Instead of that, they can directly give 12T. Why they are giving 12T epsilon? If suppose you are using a high strength steel which are imported from the foreign country, means our code have a provisions for. Okay, then coming to the next one. Pitch. The distance between the center of the fastener shall not be less than 2.5 times nominal diameter of the fastener. Nominal diameter means actual diameter of the bolt. The minimum value is 2.5 times nominal diameter. You can provide more than that. At least that. To calculate the hole diameter, we have to add the standard clearance with the nominal diameter. That depends upon the diameter of the bolt. They have given the different ranges. According to the diameter of the bolt, they are given the standard clearance for each diameter. By using this relation, now we can get the value of E and P. Then again coming to the bearing capacity. Now we have a value of E, P, how to calculate D naught and all. What is meant by FUB? That is ultimate tensile strength of the bolt. That depends upon the grade of the bolt. Okay, where Fu is the ultimate tensile strength of the plate. In Indian made steel, ultimate tensile strength is 410. After substituting all these values in here, you can find the value of Kp, then substitute Kp, where D is the diameter of the hole. Then what is meant by T? Which T has to be used? In all the cases, you can use the minimum thickness of the connecting plates. If you are using 10 mm and 6 mm, means you can substitute T as 6 mm. I will tell the reason for that. And Fu, you should not substitute Fu as ultimate tensile strength of the plate, because in some cases, plate may crushed. In some cases, bolt may be crushed. That is the bearing failure. The weakest material will crushed first, either bolt or plate. In all the cases, you can substitute the value of Fu as least of the two. Bolt ultimate tensile strength and plate ultimate strength. For example, if you are using a 4.6 grade bolt, what is the ultimate tensile strength of your bolt? Ultimate tensile strength of the bolt is 400 MPa. For plate is 410 MPa. Least of these two is 400. You can substitute the Fu value as 400, because if the plate is having high strength, mean it will crush the bolt. If the bolt is having high strength, mean it will crush the plate, the bearing failure. This is quiz time. The question for you is, the design shear capacity of the bolt has to be decreased if the packing plate thickness exceeds dash mm. We have four choices. Choose the right answer. The time starts now. Correct option is, correct answer is option C, 6 mm. Thank you. Your queries, post your queries, comments.